G'day guys, back again. Hope you're all doing well. Just recently I picked up this set from Black Dog, so I thought we'd just take a quick look at this one. Just opening the packet and seeing a lot of the broken parts here. When I first pulled it out of the box, my first impression of this kit is I wouldn't buy it again. That's my first impression. For lots of reasons, which we'll go through in a second, but my first impression is, opening the box as a consumer, would I buy this kit again? No, I wouldn't. I wouldn't. And I'll tell you why. For starters, everything was jammed into this one plastic bag. So as you can see, I've got a lot of broken parts down here. You can see over here with the jerry cans, a lot of little parts being broken off. So pretty disappointed in that, as well as that, which we'll do some close-ups of. Some of the parts on this kit are absolutely shocking. Now, I think I mentioned this in one of my other videos I did quite some time ago on SAS parts, and it sort of reminded me of the older Legend pieces of resin that we're talking probably 10 years ago that were absolutely shocking. When I opened the kit up, they would have the same sort of parts from a kit but in resin, and they were a lot worse than the actual resin parts. So this sort of reminds me of that. Some of the parts are, to me, absolutely disgraceful, and you know, this is going to be a bit of a scathing review, actually, because it's not often I do this, because most of the stuff I buy, I know what I'm buying, and I know I'm going to be happy with it. For example, Evolution Miniatures, even Def Model these days, they're doing great stuff, Live Resin, and I think Black Dog is really doing themselves a disservice by serving this up to me. And so they're going to get a review that I think is worthy of this set. So let's get started. So look at this, guys. I mean, to me, this looks like a dog's been chewing on this. You know, when you're looking at the actual kit parts on an SAS Jeep that you're going to build, it would be much easier to actually cut the grill parts out yourself, if you look at a diagram, than to use this part here. I mean, it is absolutely disgraceful. Shite. Same with this part. I think this one's worse. I mean, look at this. I mean, seriously, are you seriously, as a company, with today's standards of kits coming out, are you really going to serve this up to someone? I mean, I'm sorry, but that is just foobar. Same as the detail on these things. I mean, you know, I've already got the Dragon kit, the SAS kit, and, you know, I don't know. Look, I don't think if you can't make something look better in resin, well, then don't put it in a resin kit. That's all I'd say. I mean, look at this. I mean, seriously. I won't be putting that in my model, so that's a waste of time. Same with this one. I mean, look at this. What is this? They've all broken off. So very poor packaging. Disgraceful. Here we go. And this happens a lot in some of these sets. You get these sets and you have the little jerry can, whatever you want to call it, holders. They're all broken off. And again, I just think if you can't do a better version of a jerry can in plastic, then just don't do it. Don't put it in the kit. Save the buyer some money, and just don't put it in your kit, and then you won't get a bit of a scathing review of dodgy casting, or serving it up to me anyway. A couple of them are okay. There's another one there, broken. Now, I'm guessing this is probably for two Jeeps, or there's enough for two Jeeps, but again, I mean, look at this resin part. If you're going to be picky about it, I mean, look at the back of that. It's all broken off. Where's this going? I don't know. It's snapped off. The edge is snapped off. To me, some of this kit almost feels, this one's a bit better. Or is it? I don't think so. Yeah, so, as I was saying, some of this kit feels like it was parts from quality assurance that they threw out into a bin and then they decided to pick it back up and serve it as a kit. That's woeful. Here's some of the machine gun parts and whatever these parts are, all broken off. Here are your jerry cans here. Now look, they're semi okay. They're not too bad, but I mean, when you look underneath, this is all the casting here is broken off the straps there or whatever. Down here, you've got some serious mild lines down the side here. The tops look okay, but again, apart from the straps, which is probably why, you know, I'd be interested in buying this kit because they're already done for you. I mean, you can even see here, it's all broken off down there. You know, I mean, I could slap a couple of jerry cans together, but I just wanted these sort of for the straps that are already molded on. But again, up the top there, I mean, seriously disappointing. Very disappointed. Again, with this one, I mean, you know, you've got the sides here, and again, this is why I bought this kit for these types of things where all the cans are already in the thing for you. And look, where's this go? I'm guessing this is supposed to join up there, but that's snapped off. So that's absolute rubbish. This one here is not too bad. You know, it's probably one of the better ones in the kit. You know, but if you're buying this sort of stuff, I think you're becoming, or you are invested in becoming a bit more of a serious modeler. And with that, you're expecting sort of quality these days when you're paying for things. So look, out of the whole kit, this is probably, you know, one of the better pieces. Couple more broken off machine guns, which, you know, I wouldn't use. I don't think they're up to par with even the Dragon kit parts, so I wouldn't use those. These parts here aren't too bad, you know, but again, the way I feel about this kit now, I think I'd prefer just to get some of my own jerry cans and do my own little bracing because this kit has left me wanting to some degree. Or to a lot, actually. Even these parts here, you know, like, I don't know, like, I suppose I'm getting used to better quality cast resin. And when I'm looking at these pieces here, you know, the amount of cleanup that I'm going to have to do to get these to look decent, I'd just be better off using separate parts and putting them together myself. There's a lot of old little sets in the Italy area and stuff like that. Do some sort of type of cans like this. And to tell you the truth, oh, guys, I can't, you know, I could use some words on this kit at the moment, I can tell you. Here's some British hats, and I'll give you another example. I mean, look at the flash on this. The air bubbles. In there, I mean, give me a break. I mean, seriously, give me a break. Look at this one as well. Nail set. I mean, I would prefer to go and get a really cheap set of what were they? Tamiya British figures, or I think they were from who knows when were they? The 70s? I don't know when they were, but I mean, seriously, rubbish. Again, look, when I look at this, I think this is pretty nice. You know, the tire. It's nice casting to pretty much one of the better pieces in the kit. You know, but again, you know, you're still getting some air bubbles in there, which I understand you do get in some resin kits, but when I've just looked through this kit, and every part basically needs some sort of cleanup on it, this one's better. Same here with the gun. Not particularly well detailed, and I'd just say, why would you bother? Seriously. I could probably go and pick up an old Tamiya kit, one of the figure kits, like you see on my videos, and get a you know, a better version of this gun out of there. Air bubble there. This pit's not bad for the, I think it's for one of the gun stands. That seems to be. It's pretty sad when one of the only good parts in the kit is basically just a pole. There we go again, broken. I mean, not sure what this is. Is this a little compass or sundial or whatever you want to call it? Very messy, not clean. I mean, you know what? If you're just starting out and you want to get the really, really old Tamiya SAS Jeep, you know, the really old one, or I think it's the only one they've done, actually, you know, then, you know, that's what I'd put these parts on, because that's what they deserve. And actually, that's probably not fair on that old Tamiya SAS Jeep, because, you know, Tamiya is a great brand, and that is an old, old kit. And this feels about that quality. Actually, not that quality, but that old, this kit. It's, it reminds me of old resin that you used to pick up, you know, 15 years ago or something, and you'd open the kit and you'd go, oh my God, did I really spend money on that? This is what this reminds me of. Here you go, you have four of these, and these aren't too bad, guys. You know, this one's broken off. Surprise. You know, these aren't bad. These aren't bad. You can save a couple of those. These are probably some of the better parts in the kit. Again, that's all broken off there. But, you know, you can salvage a couple of decent ones out of there. But as you can see, air bubbles, broken off, quality assurance, not sure where it is. Again, at least they can actually do a box reasonably well, an empty box. So, you know, those parts are usable. So that's a nice to be able to use a part from the kit. That's a new thing. Here's your little, what are they, guys? Seat cut, canvas seats or whatever, covers or whatever. Cushions as well. They're not bad. I can probably use those. More ammo. And again, you know, broken off. You know, I mean, you know, my suggestion is if you're going to do this and they're broken off and they've got air bubbles on them, well, just don't give me four. Give me 50 and I can get, you know, four good ones. These aren't too bad, you know. I'm not going to complain about these. You know, they're handy. They're different sculpted, or, you know, sculpted differently to a lot of other bags you get. So, you know, I think this is probably a nice thing that you get in the kit, just because, you know, they're not the usual sort of Tamiya shaped sort of bags, if you know what I'm talking about, that you see on lots of other SAS Jeeps. So that's a nice touch. Again, these are also nice, you know. Got a lot of detail. Whoever the sculptor was, I think they've done a good job. They're not too bad. This piece here, again, it's nicely sculpted. You know, it's nice to actually get a couple of pieces, a couple air bubbles there, but it's nice to actually get a couple of pieces out of, like, a, who knows how many pieces in this set, guys. There's heaps that actually you can actually use. This is a bit weird. This part here looks like it's coming over the buckle. And then this bit here almost looks like it's not attached to the buckle. It almost looks like it's just, I don't know. Hopefully you guys can see that. It just looks a bit odd to me. Another couple of bags. And I think, if anything, I think the bags are probably the saving grace in this kit. they're probably the nicest thing that you're going to get in this set. A couple more bags. Not too bad. I mean, that's snapped off wherever that is. It's probably around here somewhere. Look, I've got to say that if you're going to spend a lot of money, you know, detailing an SAS Jeep up with resin parts, you want good resin parts. And this part here, to me, it's not up to my standard anyway. Well, it's always nice to get a bucket, but I can get that in a cheap Tamiya set. But at least it is sculpted nicely. And minimal cleanup on that, so that is nice. Here we have a little dashboard there. And in the scheme of the way some of the other parts have been in this kit, this is actually not too bad. But would I actually use it, honestly, over the kit part? I don't think I would. I'd be betting, given that I've seen some of these parts, that, you know, there'd probably be gaps in me attaching this compared to the actual kit part. Here we go here. Couple of little rats have been chewing on this one again. Air bubbles through it. The straps aren't too bad. It's passable. Only because, probably for me, the straps are actually attached to it. And it does make it look a lot more realistic. But as you can see, I don't know. You guys can make up your own mind. Couple of little MG sort of holders. That one snapped off. Don't know why that one is. That one looks like it snapped off as well. There we have it, guys. The Black Dog British SAS Jeep Africa accessories. Waste of my money. Would I buy it again? No, I wouldn't. Mine looks like seconds that have been thrown in a bin and ripped out and served up to me. Sorry, Black Dog, but, you know, I think your Black Dog's chewed on this kit a little bit too much. So that's the review you're getting. Thanks a lot, guys, for watching, and I'll catch you later.